The fate of the Chattanooga Police and Firefighters Pension Fund now rests in the hands of the City Council.
The Pension Board has approved the proposed changes to the fund, that action coming this morning. News Channel 9's Drew Balea was there for the vote and has reaction.
Aye.
The Chattanooga Police and Firefighters Pension Fund Board unanimously approved the recommendations given by Mayor Andy Burke's task force. And this was the reaction by those who were there.
They're killing our cost of living adjustment, and they're balancing this thing on the backs of the retirees.
Kirk Salter retired 13 years ago, and he's upset that his cost of living adjustment could soon change.
I'm 70, and if I live, say, to 83, 84, you know, it's going to be a $70,000 or $80,000 cut.
Others also expressed frustration.
The proposal that's been going on, I think, hurts the men and women. It's going to hurt the recruiting. It's going to hurt the city overall.
The decision means the cost of living adjustment will be cut from 3% to an average of 1.5%. Also, new and non-vested employees will have to work longer before being able to retire. And their contributions to the fund will increase from 9 to 11% over the next 3 years.
I feel that this is a reasonable, fair solution to a difficult, complex problem.
Pension Fund Chairman Chris Wilmore was elected to the board in 2009, only a year after the fund lost one-third of its assets in the economic crash of 2008.
Since 2008, 48 states have changed their pension plans for their employees.
While half of the room left in disappointment, some in the crowd say they understand the challenges and need for change.
The reality is we know that changes have to be made to sustain the fund.
I look forward to seeing the upturn of our fund.
The changes to the fund structure will now go to the council for a first reading on Tuesday. In Chattanooga, Drew Balea, News Channel 9.
And if the pension fund changes are approved by the Chattanooga City Council, they will go into effect on July 1st. The city says the changes would save about $5 million next year and about $200 million over 25 years if passed.